The revolution will not be televised. The revolution is here. Yeah. It's Common Sense with DJ Premier. We gon' help y'all see clear. It's real hip hop music from the soul, y'all. Yeah, check it. Yeah. The perseverance of a rebel, I drop heavier levels, it's unseen or heard. A king with words can't knock the...
Educate and celebrate the N.O.L.A. Preservation Society to preserve the cultural vibrancy of New Orleans and the surrounding Gulf Coast. Several young artists and philanthropists are joining forces to organize an art exhibition, proceeds which will send 30 volunteers down to New Orleans for relief work in late June. The Boys and Girls Clubs of Hudson County and Jersey City will host a benefit art exhibition organized by the N.O.L.A. Preservation Society, a group of young volunteers led by Daniel Gurry of Jersey City. The evening will conclude with local music, poetry, dance, and food inspired by the Mississippi Delta. Art is one of the most effective means of communication and can reach people regardless of language, distance, culture, or class. Many artists from New Jersey and across the nation will be featured in telling the story of the hurricane and celebrating a culture that has contributed so much to the American way of life. Beginning on June 29th, members of the N.O.L.A. Preservation Society will be working in collaboration with the Lower Nine organization to help the efforts in New Orleans. In addition to their helping hands, the fundraising of this organization, like and others, for the past years have helped, over the past year has saved a lot of lives. And now, without further ado, I hold this up because I'm going to give this hero award to Mr. Gurry and the N.O.L.A. Preservation Society.
Ladies and gentlemen, our planet is changing. As Arctic temperatures increase and sea levels rise, natural disasters will become more frequent. We, the people, must recognize that we, alike the Earth, must change so that life can be preserved. Recently, as you all know, a vicious cyclone hit Myanmar and an earthquake shook China. These events have covered American newspapers and television screens to give attention to those in need of our support, love, and assistance. Certainly, these tragedies have created hardship, and I understand the obligation of our nation to reach out and help. There is one thing, however, that I do not understand. When I was young, my parents always told me to lead by example. Of course, I always fell short because I wasn't as behaved as our young girls and boys are here tonight. If we are to lead by example in global disaster relief, then why, almost 3 years later, after Hurricanes Katrina and Rita, have we not given our love, our support, and our assistance to our fellow citizens in need on the Gulf Coast? The mission of the N.O.L.A. Preservation Society is to preserve the cultural vibrancy of New Orleans and the surrounding Gulf Coast. Through youth outreach and annual trips to the Gulf, we will aid in rebuilding efforts. We will accomplish this goal. Isn't New Orleans 1,300 miles away, you might ask? The fact is that when individuals take the initiative to learn more about our neighbors, we will develop into more nationally conscious Americans. New Orleans culture lives in Jersey City and every single city in the United States of America. The template for success is Gulf Coast culture and is present in all the activities that our Jersey City youth enjoy on a daily basis. There would be no hip-hop without jazz or the blues, and there would be no breakdancing if not for the bombola at Congo Square. As our youth are given the tools and the knowledge, our history, we will be able to find and create our own definition of what America is. This is how we can give New Orleans our support, our assistance, and our love.
I think we should give the N.O.L.A. Preservation Society, young and old. Let's give them a round of applause.